Autism and anxiety.
I said another episode.
Oh, I thought you said we were going to do one more and then you were going to sleep.
Yeah,
you
I know.
Lied to me.
Well, I didn't mean to. I thought we'd be able to get to like a point of save.
Is this a checkpoint game?
Yeah, it does by saves.
Huh. I actually don't remember that. I thought you could just like stop it and it catch you back up. But
well, I think like certain part, like right now, like after she hit the bird, I probably could have quit it. But I wasn't 100% sure.
So it's a game that just makes no sense. And now she's a whore.
Yeah, I think I didn't hit the bird last time. And what happens is I think he hits her with a snowball. And then basically this happens. I think. I think that's what it is.
I don't know.
The snowball queen.
It is very the only
terrible nickname. Holy shit.
Yeah, I was gonna say actually one I want to
grab snowball.
I wanted to say is a horribly done, but I hate it. It's still something I will nitpick. This is incredibly cliche. Like almost everything they do, from the you know this guy's ex that you know they still kind of have like a feelings for each other, but they're not completely showing it.
This whole thing is a teen drama turned into a video game, and I fucking hate it. Please, no. Why did you do that?
Because remember, it
I wanted it to end.
Actually, I don't remember what happened. That was kind of just impulse.
Damn you. No, wait, yeah, because I did the same thing. Yeah, I remember this, because I fucking accidentally clicked triangle 2, or whatever it was at the time. I saved their lives, even though I was trying to kill them. I remember that for a fact.
I think it's saved now. I think whoever does a status update, it will save.
Okay. Next time on the episode, actually, we're ending prematurely, because I fucked this game.
I'm curious, hold on. Because they don't actually tell you what you changed.
Huh. The soul.
Oh, no, okay, yeah. They wouldn't have died.
Whose side are you on?
Yeah, they wouldn't have died. Yeah, because these are all points where someone can die or someone can live. Like, this one, Sam respected Chris's privacy. Chris was happy to see Sam because of said privacy. Chris shot the squirrel, so then nature bit back and bird attacked Sam. And then, you know, Ashley encouraged Matt to use a telescope. Matt saw Mike and Emily flirting. So it explains, like, every butterfly effect you've done.
You remember that movie we're trying our fucking hardest to rip off?
Yeah, not really. Because that was like, what, him going back in time to change things? Yeah, he was going
back. I don't remember.
Yeah, it's Ashton Kutcher. I want to say he was going back in time to change things. Like him.
That's why I don't remember, because everything he was ever in, I don't fucking remember. Because
the
70s
show?
I hated that, dude.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit, I hated that show.
Okay, don't get me wrong, I didn't love it as much as everyone else, because people, like, everyone.
I watched it, and I watched the 80s show. I couldn't stand either of them.
Put that show on, like, repeat, man. And it gets old after a while. But I still love the 70s show.
Not my thing. I hate sitcoms of any kind.
Now, I remember watching Butterfly Effect a couple of years ago, so I can't say if I still like it now, but I do remember I enjoyed it at the time.
Honestly, whether I liked it or not is irrelevant. I just don't remember anything about it.
I remember a little bit. Sure. Let's just hear about women.
Women washing dishes.
See, this is the part. This is the thing I'm talking about. Like, why do I even need a swipe?
Crowds scare me.
It has a few
crowds of women are scary.
It's not really the drowning or the heights.
Just pick all right.
It's kind of more of a. Sure, I'll go with that. Well, I'm kind of more saying the creatures in the ocean.
Yeah, that's true. Then again, drowning because one's holding you down
in
the water.
I literally carry a knife and gun on me all the time. Well, not right now, since I'm technically on probation suicidal.
We're on double probation now.
Yeah, well, I am.
I'm always on probation. My probation of not giving a shit about what we're doing. Clowns! Caw!
Yeah, because I remember actually this part I did, like, coach you through. Because I was like, pick this, pick this, pick this, pick this, pick this, pick this. Because I wanted something different. Oh, yeah, this was supposed to be a jump scare.
Huh?
That was supposed to be a jump scare.
Really?
We can't hear it. He slams his hand on the desk.
Because, like, I was just kind of looking up, and I'm in a half daze, because I won't lie, I've completely clocked out of this. I do not care. You people think I'm acting up. No, I'm sitting here not paying a slightest bit of attention. I fucking hated this game the last time. Now that we're doing it again, holy shit.
You know what? I think this is the first game. Yeah, this is the first game we've ever actually, like, screwed up on and just actually went back.
I mean, we were going to do the same thing with Street Fighter because we just had trouble with it.
Oh, but, yeah, okay. Well, yeah.
We never got around to it.
Yeah, we decided on once all the characters come out.
Yeah.
Which...
We will return to Street Fighter.
Buki...
I mean, we could play 4, but... I like 4. I like 5.
No, I know. At one point, we're going to play all of the Street Fighters and all the Mortal Kombat.
We have way more money and fan bases.
All the Tekkens, yeah.
People watching this, tell your friends. Seriously, I say this every episode because you jackasses aren't doing your job.
Not every episode, every recording session, yes.
Exactly. But...
And so actually, funny thing is, it's probably why we don't have that much of a fan base. I think we're...
Because I talk shit to our fans too much.
That too.
No, they like it. They're all masochists or whatever.
But no, like,
you are masochists, right, fans? Leave your comments below of how much of a masochist you are.
I'm a sadomasochist. But like every,
I should probably stop fucking that.
Every like Let's Player. I feel like even like ones that say they don't talk up everything a little bit.
Yeah.
Whether if they
they do it intentionally or not, if it's just something that happens because of how they are.
Yeah, like they do it intentionally or not intentionally. It's just like they know it gets more views, and like maybe they start doing it as a test, and then they start doing it, you know, unintentionally. I don't know. Anyways, we never do. The only thing we really ever have, quote unquote, hyped is I always wait for a couple seconds because I always have a feeling you have something to like, you have your last 2 cents to say at the end,
especially this game, because fuck this game. But thinking of shout outs, there's actually a guy I ran into the other day. It was
we're giving shout outs now.
You talked about your entire time and your field of people at Valley or
whatever. I thought you were talking about like another YouTube bro.
No, I was heading back home from doing a bit of yard work at another friend's house, and you know the house right next to me that's pretty much abandoned?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody had asked a friend if they could come and chop one of the completely dead trees down. That's fine. And I ended up running into him, you know, helped him out a bit. Long story short, he ended up saying, like, I'm going to check out y'all's channel. So if you're watching this, hi, dude. I cannot think of your name because we talked for, like, maybe 30 minutes. So, you know, didn't really get enough
Josh. Time. He's the one.
It was something with a J. I'm almost positive. It might have been something like
that. Sorry. I just remember our previous recording, you constantly were like, Josh is the killer. He was asleep. He was drunk. He didn't help his sisters. He's the killer. you were not letting up. You're like, he's the killer.
Was I right?
You know what? I don't think anyone's actually going to care about the game itself. But at the same time, I feel like they might.
Just after recording, tell me.
I have before.
There is
a killer, but I'm not gonna say.
All I remember is space aliens, and I'm saying space aliens for a reason because I actually do know
the Predator vision.
Yeah, well, not even that. Just
all I knew it was something like more than like a slasher film because of that Predator vision.
Yeah, no, freaking a certain female friend of mine who may or may not watch the series will go unnamed because she will chew me out. Is
Which freaking, we will end up breaking that rule sooner or later. I think we have already.
I know. No, like, she'll just give me shit for it later, and I don't want to hear. But she got pissed at me when I pretty much called the entire game. Because she was like, oh, I'm not going to tell you anything. You guys are going to play the game and learn the story yourself. Because she played it long before either of us, as far as I know. And I was like, it's a Wendigo, isn't it? She's like, you fucking looked it up, didn't it?
And now you just ruined it.
Oh, shit, I did.
Yeah.
Whatever, who cares?
Well, you only ruined one half of it.
Yeah.
So,
but like, just right off the bat, I was like, oh, this is in a cabin with a bunch of Native American shit? It's a Wendigo. It has to be.
It wasn't until like half, because they keep implying like a serial killer.
Yeah.
So I kept thinking about, you know, like there's a serial killer out there. And like the Predator vision was just like aesthetic.
Yeah.
But until like halfway through the game, I started noticing, like, you'll notice I keep calling it Predator vision, but the Predator vision will start like moving a lot more. Like, it's not just kind of,
it's just not just there.
Yeah, it's not kind of just hanging around. Yeah. Am I supposed to follow Josh? I don't remember.
I don't fucking know. But like, even when you were telling me about this game, what was it like? Not even 5 minutes into your talk, I was like, oh, it's a Wendigo, isn't it?
Yeah, you're like, it's a Wendigo. I was like, you've looked it up, didn't you?
Fuck no. I don't give a shit. Yes, because you actually expect me to look up a game that I fucking hate. I do not give a single shit about this game, and everyone in here pisses me off. I just know it's a Wendigo because I fucking know lore. That's it.
Yeah, that is halfway through, like, I started to think, I was like, what is with the Indian shit? And then I was like, and then the Predator version, and then I put two and two together. I was like, oh, it's a Wendigo.
Because I could make a fucking movie myself.
I was like, wow. I was like, I mean, if you basically know the lore behind it, it's kind of simple.
Yeah, I mean, how they explained it was like, people are dying out in the middle of nowhere and people are going fucking crazy. It's a Wendigo. Has to be. That's just how it works. Somebody thought they were being clever by taking an old, you know, basically Scooby-Doo monster at this point. And did you know they actually made a movie about the Wendigo and Scooby became a Wendigo?
Yes.
I actually watched that movie. I hated that movie.
I don't remember if I liked it or not.
I can't remember the last time I saw a good Scooby-Doo.
Are you sure it's a Wendigo?
Yeah, it was a Wendigo.
I do remember.
It was the name of the movie. It was Scooby-Doo and the Wendigo Curse.
Oh, yeah, okay, never mind. Yeah, I do remember.
That was a bad
movie. Some reason I wanted to say it was werewolf, but yeah, no. Yeah, I remember.
There was one where they fought the Chupacabra.
Yeah, I do remember that one.
And Scooby tried to bang a Chihuahua.
Do not remember that.
I mean, like, it was implied. It was one of those, like, clearly Scooby-Doo
So I probably didn't catch it as a kid.
Yeah. No, I actually watched a lot of these recently, because I was like, people talk up Scooby-Doo all the time, and the early series sucks.
God, I've seen Scooby-Doo in forever.
Like, I actually
went... The animation has freaking, like...
Oh, it's... No, the animation of the newer series... Honestly, I watched, like, the most recent one, and how I was chewing out the Powerpuff Girls earlier, I actually have to give this new one some credit. They've... Huh. Now, a lot of times, especially with what Cartoon Network's been doing lately, it's... A lot of their shows that, like, were either serious or sub-dramas have all turned into comedies. Like... Teen Titans Go is clearly a parody.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, honestly, I'll give it that. If you don't think of it as Teen Titans, as thinking of it more of just a parody, it's actually an objectively good show. I can't stand all the singing and dancing they do. Subjectively, whatever. I really can't stand all the singing and dancing because it's just a bunch of the teen crap that everybody likes nowadays and I don't understand it. Powerpuff Girls fucking sucks, and I've already gone on that rant in our previous episode. If you didn't watch that, fuck you.
That actually bugs me. I think one of our friend Bao episodes got like, I don't know, 6-something-odd views. But then the one right before it had 0. I'm like, how the hell did they know what was going on?
But no.
I'm like, I can understand.
Watch the damn series.
I'm like, I can understand like one or two people skipping over it, but everyone.
Like, they just happen to not see it. They're like, I'll just watch current events. I don't know. I don't understand our fan base. I really don't.
I barely understand us.
That too. So, welcome to the show. But, Scooby-Doo one. It's very much a comedy. Like, and I mean, Scooby-Doo's always had its funny moments. Yeah, but this one's like, this one's taking it over the top. Like, to the point where, like, not even the cheesy monsters have anything really scary. It's a lot like A Pup Named Scooby-Doo.
Mm.
Honestly, and it's not bad. It really isn't. It's just... They didn't bring back Scrappy, but it's pretty much as bad as that.
Fun fact,
did you know that... I'm going to interrupt you anyway because I was already on a tangent.
But I know.
Did you know that Scrappy... That they made a pup named...
Unquote, playing a game.
Did you know they made pup named Scooby-Doo specifically to erase Scrappy from canon?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I love that. Because
everyone hated him.
Everyone hated Scrappy, and that's why they killed him off in the movie. And that was the greatest thing. Or, well, I think they threw him in jail. But
yeah, they threw him in jail.
Who cares? It's that's the same as killing off a character.
A lot of people talk crap about that movie, but I love it. I have... In the second one, which the second one is not as good. But I love both of them.
Did you watch the newest live-action one?
They made a new one.
Yeah, no, they got, like...
If Drew from A Scream is not Shaggy, I will not watch it.
No, this was, like, a new kid.
Okay,
like,
I'm not watching
it. Honestly, I give it some credit. I can't
remember that actor's name.
First off... Velma was hot as shit in it.
Velma was hot as shit in
older
live action.
Trust me, like, that Velma is whack. And I don't say whack anymore.
I was about to say, and I can't believe you used that word. I haven't said
whack
in a
long time. Compared to this one, she whack.
She whack.
Yes.
I'm a whack to that whack.
Right. But, and honestly, it was a very much like B-list actors
His
playing
His fingers will be on fire.
Yeah, no, like, that's why you bring a lamp, or a lantern, or a freaking flashlight or something. What would that accomplish? Ooh, pretty light. Like, he's drunk.
This is the most fun I've had in this game.
And that's the most...
And I actually kind of enjoy it.
And that's the most fun you will have with that game.
Maybe just finish the Scooby-Doo in 10 minutes or less.
No, basically, the new live-action Scooby-Doo movie is not bad. It wasn't great, but... It was a made-for-TV movie, if that says anything. Okay. But it wasn't bad. No, that's about it.
Yeah. Next time, might be in a different spot because save issues and yada, yada, yada. My dog scratched at the door. Next time.
Get off my screen. Just go. Go, people. Don't watch the same movie. I'm